Hello, I'm Simon. I'm a sales engineer at Laser 2000. Today we have the Spark Lasers Alcor femtosecond fiber laser in the lab, and I show you the quick setup of the laser and the total unboxing procedure. Let's start. Okay, now that everything is on the table, I'll show you what was inside the box. First, we have some cables for the connection of the laser. It's only a USB cable and the power cable. Nothing else is needed. Then we have a quick start guide. And of course, the user's manual with the software on a USB stick, and also some test report of the laser. Then we have the main part of the laser, which is the laser head. It has two units. It's the main unit, the laser head here. In this version, it's equipped with the optional AOM, the XSight module. The laser itself has an output of 2 watt at 920 nanometers, and with the AOM we expect a little bit less power of 1.8-1.9 watt. And the other part here is the controller in 19-inch rack format. So we have a small setup here, which consists of a beam profiling camera from DataRay, a beam splitter cube, and a power meter for the power measurement. Then we have some alignment here with clamps so that we have an easy alignment, and we can set up the laser in upright position so that the aperture has the same height as for the Titan Sapphire laser, which is usually used for multiphoton microscopy setups. Okay, now the laser is aligned, so I connect the two cables, the power cable and the USB cable. Okay, now everything is connected and we can switch the laser on. There's one power switch on the back. And we have the keys in the front. Wait a second. We already installed the software on this notebook and we can click connect so it finds the laser for the USB connection. Okay, now we are ready. So we put on some laser safety goggles. We have our power meter here. Then I open the aperture. And click on laser on. Okay, the power meter needs a few seconds. And we have an output power of approximately 1.9 watts. We also have the beam profiling camera here, which shows a nice beam profile. And in the next step, I set the laser power to 50% to see the function of the AUM. Wait a few seconds until power meter is ready. And now we are at 50% power. Okay, thank you for watching. And if you have any questions or feedback, contact me in the contact details we describe below the video. Thank you.